boys and girls. I'm so glad to see you this morning. I hope you had a very wonderful day yesterday. Christmas Day, such a fun time, such an important thing to remember that we're celebrating the birth of Jesus, isn't it? Such a wonderful time to have a happy birthday party for Jesus. And I hope you had got some fun presents, some fun gifts, and I hope you gave away some fun gifts. We're going to talk today about gifts, and so get ready. We're going to sing first, and then we're going to have a story about someone who brought gifts. Are you ready? Okay, let's get set. Here we go.
Wow! Oh, wow! Shout wow! Jesus can do anything. Wow! Oh, wow! Shout wow! Jesus can do anything.
Christmas present. I can't wait to see what it is. An alphabet puzzle? This is so great. Every letter is here. Wait a minute. Uh-oh. The letter W is missing. There's so many words we can't make without the letter W. W is for wings. without the letter W, I can't have my favorite breakfast. W is for waffles. I can eat all of them. This puzzle's so fun, but I don't know what to do about the letter W. It's Ollie!
Hello, Hayden. Missing an important letter, are you?
Oh, hi, Ollie. Miss Kathy Sue gave me this cool gift, but I can't find the letter W.
W is a wonderful letter. It's true. And I have a special W word for you. Listen to this story. Just follow me through.
Follow me through. Follow me through. Ollie's got a Bible story for me and you.
Huh. Oh, hey, everyone. I'm Justin the Mailman, and it's great to see you. I just found this gift in my mail bag. It didn't get delivered before Christmas, so I want to make sure I get it delivered today. You know, we can keep celebrating that God gave us Jesus even after Christmas Day. Every day is a great day to celebrate Jesus. In fact, I have a story about some people who celebrated Jesus after he was born. Here, let me show you. I'll just put the story mail in the mailbox and... This part of the true story of Christmas begins with wise men. W is for wise men. Everyone say, W is for wise men. W is for wise men. The wise men knew that God was sending someone very special, and they wanted to see him. Then, one night, they saw a very big, beautiful star in the sky. The wise men knew they needed to follow the star. Wait, where did the star go? Does anybody see it? There it is. Quick, wise men, follow that star. Whew, you did it. Wait, there it goes again. Anyone see it? There, wise men, follow that star. Wow, the wise men had to follow the star for a long time, didn't they? Well, finally, they saw the star stop, and under the star, they saw a house. Now, who do you think is living in that house? Let's find out. When the wise men got to the house, they found Jesus. Is that who you guessed it would be? Let's see what happens next. When the wise men saw Jesus, they knew he was the very special person they were looking for. He was the one God sent to show his love for everyone. So the wise men bowed down and worshiped him and gave him their very best gifts. Then they celebrated that Jesus had been born. That is an awesome story. The wise men traveled a long, long way to give Jesus gifts and worship him. They knew that God gave us Jesus because he loves us so much. Oh, hey there, Ollie. Tell me, how do we know God loves us?
God gave us Jesus. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, how do we know God loves us?
God gave us Jesus. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. I'll see you next time.
So there's your story, and it's all true. The wise men celebrated Jesus, and we can too.
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you.
Wow, the wise men followed the star to find Jesus. God loves us so much that he gave us Jesus, and we can celebrate him all year long. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good! Wait a minute, there's something in the bottom of the bag. It's the missing letter W! Now we have the letter W for wise men. W is for wise men. Bye, see you next time.
Good job, boys and girls. Good singing as always. And we've talked about the wise men before this Christmas, haven't we? We've talked about how they came and followed the star to get to Jesus. But I want to talk just a little bit to you about the presents that they brought. Now, I don't know if you caught that, but they brought three things. It was called gold, which we know is very important and valuable, and frankincense and myrrh. All of those were pretty awesome gifts to bring to a little baby. Not things that we would bring, but they were great gifts. And I want to talk about to you about why the wise men brought those gifts. Do you think they brought them because someone said, if you don't bring him gifts, you won't get to see him? No, I don't think so. Do you think they brought gifts because they said, oh, he just probably should, this would be a good thing to do? No, I don't think so. I think they brought the gifts to Jesus because they knew how important he was, and they had come to want to worship him and want to love him. And they brought gifts to say that to him, that he was important to them and that they loved him and they wanted to worship him. Now, you know, boys and girls, we can bring Jesus those same kind of gifts. Now, we're not going to bring gold or frankincense or myrrh. We don't even know what some of those are for sure. And Jesus really doesn't need a new pair of shoes or a basketball or a game to play. Those are things that are fun for us. But what gifts do you think we could give Jesus? Yes. Most of all, we can give him our love. We can decide in our hearts to tell Jesus we want to be his friend, to ask him to forgive us for the wrong things we do, and to just be close to us all the time. And that's a wonderful gift that we can give Jesus. We can also tell him how much we love him. We can talk to him. When we pray to Jesus, it's kind of like a nice gift. You know, when someone talks with me and shares with me, it's a wonderful gift that you give me. It's also a wonderful gift we give God when we talk with him. And we can listen to what he tells us we need to do. We can try very hard to always do what Jesus asks us to do. That's a great gift that we can give him. So boys and girls, as you've already opened your presents from under the tree and you're going to be playing with them this week, would you think a little bit about the gifts that you could give Jesus in this week? You could tell him how much you love him. If you haven't yet asked him to be your special friend and to forgive you for the things you've done wrong, you could ask him to do that. Wonderful gift you would give him. You can tell other people about Jesus. That's a wonderful gift too. So as we talked about the wise men today, would you just think of some of the ways that you could give gifts to Jesus and how much that would make his heart happy? All right, boys and girls, I love you so much. I love being with you. And I want us to pray together, and then we'll have to say goodbye again. Are you ready? Okay, let's pray. Jesus, we are so grateful that you came to earth to take care of the problem we have with the sins that we commit and the bad things we have done. I thank you so much that you came from a perfect heavenly place by your Father and came here and suffered for us, came here as a tiny baby, a helpless baby, and loved us so much that you wanted to do that so you could be our very special friend. I pray that you would help each one of us, these boys and girls, and even adults that may be listening, to think about what kind of gifts we can give back to you. Gifts of our obedience, the gifts of our love, the gifts of talking with you and trying to do what you ask us to do. Help us, Father, to give you those gifts this season. We love you very much and we thank you for your presence. Amen. Good job, boys and girls. Have a good week. We'll see you again next week. Bye-bye.